sudden here. It's third down. They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. We're back to Lambeau following these words. So third down now. They need the 27-yard line for a first. Now the man from UTEP, this is Aaron Jones. And he's able to pick up the first down here before he goes down at the 26. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains. On first down, Rodgers. Over the middle, that's caught by Adams. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs. On first and 10, here's Rodgers. His pass caught at the 4. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Second down, here's Rodgers. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
This defense not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. He came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
They'll try to run for it. Here's Williams. And he's not even going to get back to the line of scrimmage. And now before this 4th-and-2 play comes to fruition, they're going to think about it and call a timeout, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. The offense staying out. They're going to go on 4th-and-2. They'll go for it. It's Rodgers. Touchdown, Packers! Randall Cobb in the final seconds of the first half. And the Packers are within an extra point of tying this thing up.
That's one of the better examples of clock management I've seen. Whittled it all the way down just about and still put the ball in the end zone.
And just a methodical drive and something really to take into the lockers here. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This will be taken in at the 1. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. Before this next series gets going here offensively, what about that Saints-Vikings game?
There's so many different ways we can go and so many comments we can start with, but I hope you don't mind me starting with this one. Never in the history of the NFL, all right, did we ever think that Drew Brees could lead a team that scores and leaves just 29 seconds on the clock, and he left too much time for Case Keenum.
For Case Keenum.
Think about that.
Yeah.
All right?
Just the end of that game, you know, we say it all the time, but you live for those moments. Now, you also got to remember, for the Saints, we're thinking about the Vikings, for the Saints, what heartbreak?
Heartbreak for Marcus Williams, especially the safety. People are going to identify him as the key. But there's one thing to keep in mind. Kyle Rudolph, the tight end for the Vikings, ran about a 7-yard route, and someone from the Saints defense jumped him and actually weakened the back end of that defense and left it in a 2-on-2 situation, and the Vikings took advantage of it.
One we'll be talking about for years. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. The Packer offense now ready to get back onto the field. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter three.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up. Caught left side by Cobb. It's a big play that time for the Packers. 42 yards.
That was a nice pickup. Some chunk yardage there. Some of those big yards downfield with a little bit of rack thrown in there, a little run after catch, and it came on a crossing route. I could just hear one of my friends who won 4 Super Bowls as a quarterback always said the same thing. What route does a defense hate? Crossing route. Hate it, hate it, hate it, because it's hard to change direction when they get going full speed in the other way.
Offense still needing 10 yards, second down. Shift together here from the D-line. Rodgers gonna throw, and the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's gonna make the big play? Well, they're slinging it, and then there's one you gotta put a timer on, huh? I mean, that one came in hot.
That came in hot, but overthrown, out of his reach and incomplete. And the 10-year vet knocks it through the goalpost. And they take the lead here now at 10-7. So he splits the uprights there, and I would imagine it's nice as a kicker. Right when it leaves your foot, you know it's good.
Yeah, it's kind of like a golfer that picks up his tee after a nice drive without even watching it land.
Solid analogy. I like it. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. The Cardinals offense now ready to get their first opportunity here in the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
Time running out here on the play clock. So that'll back him up 5.
Hurry up, here we go. Green, 39.
To throw on second down, Stanton. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That one goes for 24 yards. And now a first down following that long gain.
Let's go.
They give it to Williams, running right. There he goes, right side. Touchdown, Cardinals. Kerwin Williams, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Cardinals have taken the lead. He's given him a little jolt, just gave him the lead there, but 2 TDs now in the game.
And that jolt puts them in the lead. What a terrific job by him. He is carrying the ball and simply saying, I want to win.
And now he's hoping his defense has that mentality as they try to hang on to that lead. Set to return, this is Jeff Janis. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. Now the Packers get set to go. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants to drive in with a kick other than the extra point. That's it.
Looking to throw on second down. Rodgers, he completes it to Jordy Nelson. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. The Packers on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. Shotgun now for Rodgers. And Adams has it complete. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. 5 yards on the play there as the drive will continue. Throwing on first down is Rodgers. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. A good first down call as the screen play gets him 9.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
Back now at Lambeau. It's the Packers who have the football but in need of points as we begin quarter number 4. This is the fullback, Rutkowski, and he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains.
Brandon, you know how we talk about having wrinkles in a game plan? That was a fold right there. How about that play? Being able to change things up, you think anyone else on the team's going to get the ball? And in that situation, they surprise everyone and give it to their big guy.
And he'll be brought down at about the 42. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd-and-9. Under 4 to go now as the clock runs, and they come up on 2nd down. Here's Rodgers to throw on 2nd down. And his throw is incomplete.
And we just saw another example. These cornerbacks have played tight coverage all game long. Might start wanting to think about a few double, triple move routes to try and shake their guys free.
Because they have, you're right, they have had no room to breathe. On 3rd down, here's Jones. And heavy contact. He is knocked down hard. Looks to be right around the 40. 2 yards on the pickup there. It's 4th down. Here's Rodgers. And that is incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Cardinal defense is going to get the football back. And he'll have a tough time living that one down. It's one thing, Charles, to drop a pass. It's quite another to drop it on 4th down.
And so many teams work on that in terms of locking in on those key downs. You know, I've seen, you know, you and I have both been to practices where we've seen, hey, 3rd down situation, big 3rd down alert, lock in here. 4th down play, make sure you focus just a little bit extra. It didn't pay off in that situation.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. On 2nd down, Williams. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. And now the Packers going to take another timeout. That's going to be their 2nd. They'll be left with 1 more plus the 2-minute warning. And we'll be back. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is 3rd and long. From the gun, Stanton. It's caught, Nelson. And he's going to get this down. Yard line.